first tool which I have for you. So probably the ones who are there, I'll be sharing through the chat itself here. Next, we move up to, I hope we are clear about all the filters and this verbal thinking or the thinking indicator tool. Any questions, anybody? You can raise your hand. Next, we move on to, we talked about the tone of voice last time. Right now, we are going to talk about the types of the tone of voice. We know that 93% of our communication is through non-verbals, which can be tone of voice or which can be body language. But the importance of the tone of voice comes in. How is it that we are using our tone? Like, it can be a funny tone or a serious tone. It can be a formal tone or a casual tone. It can be a respectful or irrelevant, either of them. And fourth is, it can be an enthusiastic or matter of fact type of a tone of voice. A few examples around these very things. So first one, if I talk about taking at least one of all the four. First one, if you are to state something in a serious, formal, respectful, and matter of fact tone, it can be stated as, I apologize, but I am experiencing a problem. So it is serious, it is formal, respectful, as well as it is a matter of fact, there is some problem, and as a matter of fact, I'm just mentioning that to you. Second example, serious, only the formal changes to casual, still respectful and a matter of fact. I'm sorry, but I'm experiencing a problem at my end. More or less similar, but I apologize becomes a little more formal and I'm sorry becomes a little casual. Otherwise, more or less, it is similar. The next type of tone of voice, serious, casual, respectful, and matter of fact, this time changes to being an enthusiastic tone of voice. Oops, I'm sorry, but I'm experiencing a problem at my end. More or less similar if you look at either of the second and the third one. But this time just that oops at the start gets added, which probably shows it in a more enthusiastic manner. You would have seen many a times that right now, even some tools, Amazon, if you're using the Amazon app and somehow you're unable to get to a specific page, and then suddenly a dog photograph appears. Uh-oh, something's not right. That is more probably not serious, I would say, but yeah, casual and enthusiastic. So this type of a tone of voice they're trying to show using that app. And this is also something you use. Of which one to use and how to use is something that you will need to make a choice for. Next is serious, casual, irrelevant and enthusiastic. Now here, when we are talking about irrelevant, it is that irrelevance is not to the person, or it is just irrelevant to the way he expresses or she expresses it. That irrelevance. What did you do? You broke it. Hey, I was just kidding. I'm experiencing a problem at my end. This is more, okay, I wouldn't even say, this seems, sounds a little irrelevant. The type of tone that this was stated in the initial manner. Enthusiastic, yes, it is. Casual. Seriousness, why? Because yes, still the second part of the statement, I'm experiencing a problem at my end, conveys the same. So actually it is a mix and match of these four types of tones of voices that we can look at. And whenever we are speaking, what is the type of tone of voice that we make use of? Maybe when we are addressing our teams, some specific team leaders would like to use the first one. Serious, formal, respectful, and matter of fact. Hey, I am the boss. And some others, they might probably prefer serious, casual, irrelevant, and enthusiastic. That also depends on the type of team members that you have in your team and how they perceive you as their leader. What type of a bonding you share. Just to highlight a few facts, about the tone of voice. So Margaret Thatcher, she hired a vocal coach to help her develop a voice of authority and leadership. There is a site called Awesome Stories where you can find the details about this. That is the importance of the tone of voice. Doctors who use the wrong tone of voice when speaking to patients are more likely to be sued for whatever they've done. And this is coming straight from the National Library of Medicine. So the doctors who have a good tone of voice and connect well with the patients, usually they tend to not get sued. Communication matters. Men with deeper voice tonality are paid more. That's a good thing, huh? So you should have a deeper voice. And the reference is actually, there is something, a research which was conducted in Duke University and University of California. And when they did it, they actually studied some organizations and some leaders. And then they found out that the men who have a little deeper voice tonality, they tend to get paid more than the ones who have a shriller voice. And women's voices are judged more harshly than men. And this is coming from Tara Moss's book, Speaking Out, a 21st century handbook for women and girls, she has written.
Oh, God.
These are a few facts, of course. We can't fight the facts. Huh?
Correct.
Now, I want to say that women are always
please.
Judged more harshly.
Sorry?
Being a feminist, I'll say that women are judged more harshly in all the aspects.
Thank you. I think, yes, you are right also, Isha. And maybe we can discuss this when we are conducting a session on femininity and diversity. Maybe.
Of course.
Okay, just joking. All right. Thank you, Ram. Thank you for the
comment. I'm all hands on that.
Sorry, I know you are. Thank you. Let's move on. So we talk about assess the components. First one, volume of voice. This is an important aspect. If I am speaking too slow, are you able to understand what I'm trying to tell you? If any one of you understood what I just said, can you just mention it? Am I audible?
Yes.
What did I just say?
You were just asking if you were audible or not.
No, before that. That is the difference volume of the voice makes.
Yeah.
I just wanted to. Correct. Yeah, could not hear. Gaurav also says could not hear. So basically, what is the volume of voice that you are making use of? That is what makes the difference. You need to know what is the volume which will get you through to the other people who are sitting, whether it is a public speaking forum or it is a normal type of a discussion where you are sitting face to face. Next one, extending and controlling your pitch. Important? Projecting your voice. How confident you are gets projected by your voice. Vary your rate of speech. This is important. Somebody who understands or probably speaks a little slow, he will or she will prefer if you also try to match the rate at which he or she speaks. Believe me, that is a big, very good tool when we talk about building rapport. If I'm speaking too fast, I'm not sure how much can you make out of whatever I just said. However, if I just tend to become a little slower, I am sure you'll be able to comprehend what I'm trying to convey. Right? Can you just make out?
Correct. Yeah. Like, pehle aap bahut tez bol rahe the, and then you were speaking really slow.
So it was that variation which you tend to imitate the speaker. Right, as Gaurav states in speech, these are the gestures. Yes, they are. One thing, I just recall, there was once an article in one of my college time, there was a magazine, Campus Digest. So this is around us pauses while speaking. So somebody had written a mail to her husband or someone and had forgotten to put the commas and the full stops. And then the lady again opened the letter and then put in the commas and full stops wherever she felt like theek hai kahi bhi dal do yaar. And then how the meaning actually changes.
Oh, correct. That's so right? True, sir.
And that exactly is what happens when you are communicating. Jab aap baat bhi kar rahe hote ho kisi se, main abhi aapse baat kar raha hu, agar main sahi jagah pe pause nahi lunga to
meaning different ho jata hai pura.
Pakdo mat jaane do.
पकड़ो मत जाने दो
जाने दो एकदम उल्टा. दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन एग्जांपल्स वी हैव हर्ड ऑफ.
करेक्ट.
इफ आई जस्ट टेल यू वो दो लाइनें मेरे को बड़ी अच्छी से याद थी एंड आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हेन आई वाज इन क्लास 8th और 9th व्हेन आई रेड दिस. तो तुमने जस्ट अ सेक लेट मी टू पिक और सुनिए हां सो तुमने पत्र नहीं लिखा कुत्ते के बच्चे भेड़िया खा गया है. सो एक्चुअली व्हाट द लेडी मेंट वाज तुमने पत्र नहीं लिखा फुल स्टॉप कुत्ते के बच्चे भेड़िया खा गया है.
करेक्ट.
इंस्टेड इट मेंट तुमने पत्र नहीं लिखा कुत्ते के बच्चे फुल स्टॉप. सो इट चेंजेस द मीनिंग एंड दैट इज व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन यू आर स्पीकिंग. आपके पॉजेस कॉमास कहां लग रहे हैं और फुल स्टॉप्स कहां लग रहे हैं जब आप बोलते हैं. So that is something which really will help in terms of having effective communication. Then let us now look at the second tool. This tool is a speech profiler for you or a speech profile assessment. So basic, some inputs are there in terms of what it is all about and how voice is produced. Some basics are there. This is just for your information. You can read through this. Then the instructions come in. Before the speech, arrange to have someone evaluate your voice. Because remember that you cannot actually assess your own voice. What you say while you say, you whatever you listen is different. So either you record your voice and then you listen to it and then fill this up, or else have someone evaluate your voice. This again is as per the science of communication. After the evaluation, you may want to draw a line connected the marks on this profile, or you may not want to. That's totally up to you. But yes, do remember that any characteristics that you rate as 4 or less on this scale indicate the possible voice challenges that you are facing, and you might want to look at, there are different exercises. So though I've just stated some 3 in this tool, if you need more, you can always get in touch with me. A few exercises, of course, as I said, evaluator needs to identify the each characteristic on the speech profile, and during the presentation, rate each characteristic on a scale from 1 to 7. 1 is the lowest and 7 is the highest. Write your name here, put in your date. What is it that we are talking about? Loudness or volume, there are 3 things which are to be checked. Whether the person was too quiet or was able to project the voice well. Was inaudible or was heard easily? Was the volume flat or was he vibrant or she vibrant while he or she was speaking? Pitch, high or low, shrill or full pitch, and whether the pitch was monotonous or it varied. Voice quality, whether he was Himesh Reshamy, nasal, or was it open? The way he sings, huh? Okay, used to sing. Next, breathy or is it clear? So is it that the voice of your breath is coming along whenever you're speaking, or is it clear? I have included one of the exercises for this as well. Is the voice quality harsh or is it mellow? There are a few people who tend to always be harsh. That is their natural style. Is the voice quality lifeless or full of enthusiasm? Next comes in a few items which are around the verbal aspects of communication. Is the person slushy while he or she is speaking or clear? Lazy lips. अब हम का बताएं भैया बहुत परेशानी है. Is a lazy lips. To the point. काम करो. Okay. Let me cite one from the movies. When you have to shoot, shoot. Don't talk. Probably to the point. tangled tongued either ways. कभी कभी जब हम बोलते हैं तो ऐसे हो जाओ. सो दैट इज टैंगल्ड टंग्ड व्हाइल कंट्रोल्ड. अ टाइट जॉ और एन ओपन माउथ. व्हेनेवर यू आर स्पीकिंग ट्राई टू ओपन योर माउथ एज मच एज यू कैन. दैट ब्रिंग्स इन क्लैरिटी ऑन हाउ यू आर स्पीकिंग. मंबलिंग और अगेन प्रोजेक्ट्स वेल. मिसप्रोनंसिएशन और प्रोनंसिएशन. On this scale, where does the person stand? Timing and pace. If the person is jerky or smooth, the way in which he or she speaks. Is the person slow or fluent? Unvaried or varied in terms of the pace as well as the timing. So there are a few things that the person might want to say at a faster pace than the others. Next one would be around being hesitant or being deliberate. Vocal variety, emotionless or emotional, unfriendly or genial, strained or natural, dull or vital. This is the vocal variety through which the person can communicate in an effective manner. Now, a few things or a few exercises which I have shared with you. First one is, remember that this is a warning. Any exercises should not be done for more than 5 to 6 minutes maximum, usually spreading throughout the day. In case if there is a serious problem, please try and consult a therapist, speech therapist. Don't try these. Voice relaxation, there is a 6-step method. You can just read through this and maybe practice this. Similarly, for projecting your voice, when you're projecting your voice, and if you have some breathiness in your speaking, you can try and then work on this exercise. Simple exercises, making an E sound while recording a voice. The breathiness or escaping air will be heard. Repeat it until the vocal tone and the rush of air can be heard independently of one another. Similarly, then practice it on R. So these are actually proven exercises which help you work and develop your speech. And another one is around managing your rate of speech. So ideally it is said that a slow speaker reads about 120 words per minute, and if it is a fast speaker will read more than 190 words per minute. So all that you need to do is have a stopwatch. I have put in here the speech given by late Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Saab, one of his finest speeches given at IIT Hyderabad, where he articulated what are his 3 visions for India. And I've just mentioned that, and in after every 50 words, you will find a slash mentioned. It can be anywhere in the middle of a sentence, at the end of the sentence. It just tells you 50 words are over. You can use this tool to help you get a grasp of what is your speed and whether you should slow down or you should pick up speed. So this is the second tool that I'm going to share with you. Are we on the same page?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Moving on, I have another example for the tones. So this is a speech from Michelle Obama. Just try and relate to what was the type of tone she used and what she meant. As I end my time in the White House, rising tone, wanted to continue the statement. I can think of no better message. Fall and rise. And then she is disappointed. I can think of no better message to send to our young people. She is sad. In my last official remark as First Lady, this is a certain thing which she is mentioning. So for all the young people in this room, there is hope. So for all the young people in this room falls, while till then this rises, the tone rises. So if you look at these things, this is how you can make out the meaning of the type of words that are being mentioned. I'm not just going through the complete thing, but basically you can make out. And this is what this tool will help you also develop in yourself in terms of how you can develop your tones or your speech, specific aspects of your speech, which bring out to the others what is it that you want to convey, how you want to convey it.